We're gonna be squaring some binomials here. What's that? You don't see binomials? Check this out. 81 squared, that's the square of 80 plus 1. So you got 80 squared, 6400, plus 2 times 80 times 1, that's another 160, brings us up to 65. 60 plus that extra 1 squared brings us to 65. 61, next problem. 205 squared, that's the square of 200 plus 5. 200 squared, that gives us 40 grand. Then 2 times 200 times the 5, that gives us another 2 grand, 42 grand. Then you gotta add on the 5 squared, that gives us 42,025. Next problem, 98 squared, that's the square of 100 minus 2. 100 squared is 10 grand minus the 2 times the 100 times the 2. That gives us a minus 400, takes us down to 9,600. You gotta tack on that 2 squared, that's 4, 9,604. And then, oh, you want me to slow down a little bit? All right. I'm gonna walk you through what we're doing here, what I'm doing here, and then you can help me out on the last one, all right? What we're doing here is we're squaring binomials. That's what we're doing here. Now, when you first look at that, you're gonna think, hey, x squared plus 5 squared, it's x squared plus 25. If you learn only one thing from this video, I want you to learn this right here, this big red knot. The square of x plus 5 is not x squared plus 5 squared. If you don't believe me, let's try. X equals 1. Put x equals 1 in here. 1 plus 5 is 6. 6 squared is 36. Put the 1 in over there. 1 squared is 1. Add on 5 squared, which is 25. You get 26. 36 is not 26. These two are not equivalent, all right? I want you to say it with me, not equivalent. Not equivalent. Got it? All right, now let's figure out what the square of this is equivalent to. We'll go ahead and write this as the product of two binomials because that's what it is. And we have x times x gives us x squared plus 5x, and then x times 5 gives us another plus 5x. So we have two copies of 5x. That gives us a plus 10x. We have an extra term there. Plus 5 times plus 5 gives us the plus 25. So sure enough, we have an x squared, we have the 25, but we also have this middle term. And check out where that middle term came from. We have the plus 5 times the x. Then we have another x times the plus 5. We have two copies of this 5x there. Two copies of the product of these terms. 2 times 5x gives us that 10x. Not x squared plus 5. You remember that knot. All right, here we go. Next problem. Once again, we'll write this as the product of two binomials, c minus 7 times c minus 7. C times c, that's c squared. Minus 7 times c, and then we have c times minus 7. That gives us two copies of the product of these two things. It gives us two copies of minus 7c. Gives us a minus 14c. Then minus 7 times minus 7 gives us a plus 49. All right, last one. Once again, we'll write that out as product of two binomials. And we'll start off. 3d times 3d gives us a 9d squared. Then we have two copies of 11 times 3d. There's one there. There's one there. Two copies of 11 times 3d gives us 33d plus 33d, or 66D. And then finally, 11 times 11 is 121. So now we see from this, we see the pattern when we're squaring these out. We get the first term squared, x squared, c squared, 3D squared. Then we take the second term, that's square 2, plus 5, gives plus 25, negative 7. You square negative 7, you get positive 49. You square 11, you get 121. But we also have these middle terms that come from 2 times x times 5, 10x, because we have two copies of 5x there. 2 times c times minus 7, because we have two copies of minus 7c, gives us a minus 14c. And then once again, we have two copies of 3d times 11. 2 times 3d times 11 gives us the 66d. And of course, we can tackle all of these at once by just starting with a plus b and squaring that out. You square a plus b, we can write it again as product of two binomials. Multiply the first ones, you get a squared plus ab plus ba. Put those two together, you got two copies of a times b. And then we have plus b squared. And now we see, whenever you're squaring a binomial, squaring a plus b, you have a squared and b squared, but you also have this plus 2ab in the middle. All right, so now we're going to make sure we recognize these things, recognize these squares of binomials. We're going to go the other direction. We're going to start with these expressions and try to figure out which ones of these are squares of a binomial. Now, you didn't fall for this, did you? You remember the not. This is not the square of x plus 7, because if you square x plus 7, you're going to have that middle term. You're going to have a plus 14x in the middle. So this one, not. You remember that, right? I'm going to go ahead and write it on the board there so you remember, not. All right, so then this one here, we've got x squared and 9. So if this is the square of a binomial, it's going to be the square of x plus 3. And that is 2 times 3x. So this is x plus 3 squared. We square the x, we square the 3, and we've got double the product of these terms right there. That is the square of a binomial. Then this one here, well, if this is the square of a binomial, it'll be a 2c here. Then over here we'll have a 5. Oh, wait a second. If I square negative 5, I get positive 25. If I square positive 25, I get positive 25. That negative right there, no, that's no good. This is not the square of a binomial. Let's try this one next. Square of the binomial, you're going to have a p, and then this is going to be 15 squared, so I could go p plus 15, but I see that negative sign there. If I go with a p plus 15 here, when I square that out, I'm going to have a plus 30p in the middle. I'm going to have a plus 30p. I need a minus. So this is the square of p minus 15. P squared is there. Minus 15 squared is plus 225. 2 times p times a minus 15 gives me the minus 30p. All right, this one here, once again, the first term and the last term are both squares. So it looks like this might be the square of a binomial. We'll go 3y, and then this will be a 4. And this minus sign tells me this is going to have to be a negative. So let's see if this works. 3y squared gives me 9y squared. If you square the 3y, we get a 9y squared. If we square the negative 4, we do get 16. And if we see 2 times 3y times the minus 4, does give us the minus 24y. So that one works as well. Now how about this one? If this one's the square of a binomial, we have a 2f here, and we'll have a plus 5 over there, because a plus there. And if we square that out, the square of 2f is 4f squared. The square of 5 is 25. And then 2 times 2f times the 5 gives us 20f, not 10f. That doesn't work. This one is not the square of a binomial. All right, so it's very important to be able to go both ways with these squares of binomials. We need to be able to expand them, and we also need to be able to recognize them. It makes it easy to factor expressions like this when we can just see and recognize that it's a square of a binomial. All right, now that you got this square binomial stuff down, we're ready to go back through these. I'll go through them a little bit more slowly this time, but I think you can play along this time. This one was 80 plus 1 squared. And when we square that out, we have the 80 squared plus 2 times 80 times 1 plus the 1 squared. 80 squared is 6,400. 2 times 80 times 1 is 160, and that 1 is just 1. 6,400 plus 160 is 6,560. Add on the extra 1, we've got our 6,561. 205 squared is 200 plus 5. Squared, that gives us 200 squared, plus 2 times 200 times 5, plus 5 squared. 200 squared is 40,000. 2 times 5 is 10, times the 200 is another 2,000. So that's 42,000 plus that 25, 42,025. And then 98, well, that's near 100. We know how to square 100. We have 100 minus 2 squared. So give me 100 squared, and the minus, got to be careful with the signs. The minus means we're subtracting in that middle term. Minus 2 times 100 times 2, and then plus 2 squared at the end. 100 squared, that's 10,000. 2 times 2 is 4, so we're subtracting 400 here, going down to 9,600. Then we're adding on that 2 squared to get 9,604. All right, you ready? We got the last one right here, all right? We're going to square 1,042. That's 1,000 plus 42. We're going to square that. 1,000 squared, that's a million. So we've got a million. I'm going to take that million and put it in this hand right here. I've got the million right in there. And then we need 2 times 1,000 times the 42. 2 times 42 is 84. 84 times 1,000, 84,000. I'm going to put that right in here with the million. I've got 1,084,000 right here. Then I have to add on that 42 squared. Now, you may know 42 squared off the top of your head. I don't, because I can always just do this. I'm going to square 40 plus 2. I'm going to square 40, I'm going to get 1,600. Then I'm going to add on 2 times 40 times 2. That's going to give me another 160. Brings me up to 1,760. Then I'm going to add on that 2 squared. It gives me 1,764. I'm going to take that 1,764. I'm going to put it with the stuff I have in my hand right there. And what I have in my hand right here then is 1,085,764. And we're done.